In this video, we're going to talk about biofilters, biofiltration, and how they're used in odour control. G'day Dale, how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing good.
So talk to me about biofiltration. First of all, I've got no clue. What is it actually about?
Okay, biofiltration is a form of odour filtration that we use in usually high concentration areas where the concentration of H2S or whatever other contaminants may be present in the air are up at a higher level. And carbon is not suitable because the carbon may burn out too quick. So we go to this biofilter technology.
Okay, and H2S, I think I've got this correct, that's the rotten egg
smell. That's the hydrogen sulfide, the most common air pollutant when it comes to sewer.
What are some of the other things that this technique will pull out of the air?
Biofiltration is great where it will adapt to just about anything. It's like a build it and they will come. What we do is we will fill the vessel with a media that will harbour a biomass, and that biomass will accumulate according to what's coming through. So it does have a conditioning period of say two or three weeks, but after that 2 or 3 weeks of biomass will accumulate inside the vessel and it will be adapted to whatever is coming through and will feed on them contaminants.
So it's almost a living thing.
It is very much a living thing, yes.
So you have this living thing and you pipe air through there. Is it a passive or is it an active fan system?
It's very rarely would a biofilter be passive. Almost exclusively would it be forced extraction. Yes.
Okay, good. And is this the sort of thing that I want to say runs out? Do you need to replace your biofilter mass at some point?
The beauty of biofiltration is no, you usually don't have to replace the media. We like to expect about 20 years.
Seriously?
Yeah. We get about 20 years out of the media, and even then we wouldn't expect that we would have to change it. As I said, it is a living thing and it will continue to live while we feed it. And if we're feeding it with a contaminated airstream, then it will continue to survive.
That's amazing. So it really lives on the bits that we don't want is what this biomass lives on.
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
That's kind of extraordinary. Now, in terms of a price point, I appreciate carbon filtration is more of a less expensive approach.
Yes.
What about biofiltration in comparison?
Biofiltration is a lot more complex, and therefore the capex of implementation is a bit more expensive.
So arguably a bit more expensive to actually put it together, but once you've got it, it sits there for 20 years doing a beautiful
thing. Yeah, exactly.
Thing.
Very low maintenance costs. If any at all.
Okay, no, that sounds excellent. So talk to me about some of the specific uses and applications of biofiltration, maybe certain industries or something like that.
It's very popular in the wastewater industry, so sewer applications, pump stations that have high concentrations of H2S, treatment plants, and also industrial applications, pet food manufacturing, grease trap waste, anything, like I said, that may
What are some of the, you've seen quite a few of these over the years, what are some of the more unusual, interesting cases you've seen?
I've got to say pet food is probably the most off-putting one. It's very extraordinary that they turn it into something that animals can finally eat.
Right.
When you see it in its manufacturing stage, but it's amazing that we can take care of that odour sometimes.
Not
when
bad.
I smell it. Yeah.
So if you can do that, you can probably do pretty much anything.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
I have a slightly technical question here. What is the difference between a biofilter and a modular hybrid filter system? Have I got that right?
Yes, you have. Okay, a modular hybrid system is a two-stage filter where we will combine both technologies, biofiltration and activated carbon. A perfect scenario would be, let's say, a coastal holiday town where it has a population of, say, 6,000 or 7,000 people for most of the year.
Yep.
But Christmas time, that picks up to 15,000 to 20,000 people.
Right.
And then the concentration of odours are going to also increase with that population increase. Now, the biofilter won't be able to adapt to that quick enough to pick up that breakthrough. So the activated carbon would be on the back end to take care of anything what we call breakthrough. So that would be a perfect example of when a hybrid filter would be appropriate.
So you want it with a multi-step filtration system.
Yeah, and it also would be used when we have a requirement to take, say, a 99.8% odour removal rate. So if we really need to make sure that we need to get rid of everything then that would be when we would use a hybrid system or a modular system.
A coastal sort of tourism-based city, that's of absolute critical importance.
Yes, because when that population picks up, the H2S concentration will pick up, the biofilter won't have time to be able to adapt to that because it takes a few weeks, so we have the activated carbon on the back end to take care of that breakthrough.
I've got something here that's interesting, again, might be a little technical. Is there a way for a biofilter or biofiltration system to reduce volatile organic compounds?
Yes, once again.
And what are they?
Well, VOCs are usually the breakdown of organic compounds. So H2S is the main contributor to our sewer gas smells. The VOCs is, so the leftover would usually be the VOCs.
Okay.
Again, whatever is going through that biofilter, the biomass will accumulate to take care of. So the great thing about biofiltration is it's so adaptable. It will adapt to whatever is going through. So if there's a high concentration of VOCs, then the bugs will accumulate to feed on the VOCs.
Thanks very much, Dale. I appreciate that.
Not a problem.
For those
Thank
of you,
you
who'd like to find out more, please visit us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au. That's B-U-L-B-E-C-K, enviro.com.au. And please feel free to send us an email, give us a call. We'd love to help.